Inside their leaves, plants contain chlorophyll. This pigment is responsible for the leaf's green colour, but more importantly for absorbing the light required to give the plant the energy it needs to perform photosynthesis. But photosynthesis is not the only fate for photons absorbed by chlorophyll. The energy from light may also cause damage to the plant, or may be lost as heat, either to comply with the laws of thermodynamics, or as part of a regulatory process to avoid damage. On top of this, a small percentage of the light is re-emitted from chlorophyll in a process known as chlorophyll fluorescence. Fluorescence occurs all around us. Many compounds found in nature are fluorescent, resulting in glowing rocks, glowing lifeforms, and even glowing money. But how does it work? Fluorescence occurs when a molecule absorbs light. The molecule will then be in an excited state, containing more energy than it did before. Some of this energy will be rapidly lost as heat, reducing the energy in the system as the molecule drops through various intermediate vibrational states. Fluorescence occurs when some of the energy needed to be lost to reach the ground state is emitted as a photon of light. Because some of the energy is lost as heat, this photon will have less energy than the absorbed photon, and so will be of a longer wavelength. It should be obvious, dear listener, that in order for fluorescence to occur, the absorbed light must contain more energy than the fluorescence emitted. So under red light, this page looks perfectly normal. But if viewed under higher energy, and therefore longer wavelength light, a fluorescence message becomes visible. For plant scientists, the differing absorption and emission spectra are important features of chlorophyll fluorescence. It allows for light from fluorescence to be separated from the applied light that is absorbed, transmitted, and reflected by the leaf. The different fates of absorbed photons inside the leaf are in competition with one another. So, by measuring fluorescence, it is possible for a scientist to work out what other processes are going on inside the plant. This can be illustrated if a herbicide such as DCMU is applied to the leaf, blocking all photosynthesis from occurring and causing fluorescence to increase. In the laboratory, the proportion of light resulting in photosynthesis can be effectively removed by applying a very bright saturating flash. These photons, being so numerous, will occupy all the plant's photosynthetic capacity, meaning other light is diverted away from photosynthesis. But for a plant, a photon is a photon. And so, how can we separate the fluorescence caused by the background light to discover the proportions of our photon fates? In the laboratory, we use a weak measuring light, so weak that it does not even stimulate photosynthesis. This light is rapidly turned on and off, and so background fluorescence can be simply subtracted. The use of a measuring beam isn't always possible, but fluorescence can still be useful. Total chlorophyll fluorescence is correlated with photosynthesis, and so solar-induced fluorescence can be measured from space to gain an indication of the amount of photosynthesis being performed in an ecosystem. Although only a tiny fraction of light is re-emitted as fluorescence, this has become an incredibly useful tool for plant scientists. And it means, even if you can't quite see it, the plants are quite literally glowing.